coming in first, we have Candace Smith. Up next, we have Suzanne Hetrick and Elliot Fielding. Come on out. Next up is Laura Moran and Josh Knight. Coming up, we have Katie Wolfrey and Jonathan Gardner. Right, coming out now, we have Samantha Green and Lee Williams. Coming up, we have the matron of honor, Megan Rayberg and Jason Webb. Oh, yeah. All right, we have got the second matron of honor and the best man. Give it up for Amy Adams and Adam Janey. We have got the cutest ring bearer and flower girl, Jacob Prince and Lacey Wilson. Barely know Jacob. All right, well then we will keep it going. And right now, we are going to have the bride and groom coming out. Give me just a second so that I can introduce them properly.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to get through this thing called life. Electric word, life, it means forever, and that's a mighty long time. But I'm here to tell you, something else. The afterworld.
So I need everyone right now to get up on your feet. Please get up on your feet. Do I have anybody that can do a two-fingered whistle? I need a two-fingered whistle right now. There we go. I need you guys to keep that going. I need some yes. I need some screaming. Because right now, I'm introducing to you, for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Christopher. Together. Now that we've got them together, we're going to go into the first dance. So give up the bouquet.
Our love is unconditional. We knew it from the start. I see it in your eyes. You can feel it from my heart. From here on after, let's stay the way we are right now and share all the love and laughter that a lifetime will allow. I cross my heart and promise to give all I've got to give to make all your dreams come true. In all the world, you'll never find a love as true as mine. My life complete, and as long as there's a breath in me, I'll make yours just as sweet. As we look into the future, it's as far as we can see. So let's make each tomorrow be the best that it can be. Cross my heart and promise to give all I've got to give to make all your dreams come true. In all the world, you'll never find a love as true.
When the road gets dark and you can no longer see, just let my love throw a spark and have a little faith in me. When the tears you cry in me, and have a little faith 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 in me. When you're a cigarette heart, I cannot speak so easily. Come here, darling, from a whisper start, to have a little faith in me. And when your back's against the wall, just turn around and you will see. I will catch you fall, baby. Just have a little faith in me, and have a little faith in me.
All right, everyone, if I can get your attention, I introduce to you the matron of honor, Megan. Go ahead, take it away.
Hi, Syl. First, I just want to thank Frank and Gwen for hosting such a beautiful evening. And where are they? Congratulations to you. Melanie, I think it's vitally fitting, being that this is your wedding night, that I let everyone know what SOBE stands for. What do you think? Just kidding, girl. That one's going to the grave. But in all seriousness, I could stand up here and recite pages and pages of inside jokes or recount years of memories. Priceless moments Melanie and I have shared in the more than 2 decades of knowing each other. But Melanie and I both know what we've been through, and what we've experienced together needs no explanation, no bragging, no fuss. It's not our style. It's that quiet confidence in our companionship and that unspoken respect and love we have for one another that grows stronger with each milestone we experience together and has shaped the friendship that I cherish so deeply. What I'd like to convey is how lucky I've always felt to have a best friend like Melanie. And we can all agree, she's a treasure. Selfless, caring, thoughtful, hilarious, and she is always there for everyone. And I think I speak for everyone when I tell you, Melanie, how happy I am that you found your prince. I can think of no better match for you. He is selfless, caring, thoughtful, and definitely hilarious. And he is always there for everyone. And you both, in my opinion, are shining examples of what a loyal and unconditional friend should be. And I pray that you continue to treat each other that same way in your marriage. Christopher, take good care of our girl. And Melanie, you look absolutely beautiful tonight. And I can't wait to create new pages of inside jokes and future memories with you both. So let's raise our glasses and toast to Mr. and Mrs. Prince. May the joys you share today be the beginning of a lifetime of great happiness and fulfillment. And may God bless your marriage. I love you both. Cheers. Sorry.
That was beautiful. All right. And I bring to you now the best man, Adam Chaney.
Yeah. Be nervous.
Don't smile, dude.
Mr. and Mrs. Williams, thank you very much for having us here. This is absolutely gorgeous. I'm going to take a little bit different approach from my man Prince here. I've been waiting a few months for this occasion to stand in front of friends and talk to a little bit about the choices that my man has made over the years. Today in particular, an absolutely perfect choice. I couldn't be more happy for you. You made an awesome decision. Now, I've known this man for about 16 years now. And not always have we made the best choices. So we're gonna, as best man, I feel obligated to tell you guys about some of the choices that my man has made. Now, we didn't have smartphones back then, so over the last few months, I just wish we had pictures of some of the things that we've done over the years, especially in those beginning times. Now, I was brought to my attention that we do have people in the law or something along those lines. So everything that I say today is alleged. This is an alleged things that took place in our younger years. This is not particularly a fact, but the first time I met Mr. Christopher was, we were probably about 14, it was before high school had started, you know, and I see this guy on the football field, and this guy's got the 1970s pork chops going on. I was like, is this a beard, or is this sideburns that we got going on here? But, and the deep voice, I mean, this kid was 14, hey, I'm Prince.
nice to meet you, you know?
I mean, dead serious. And I first time going to Prince's house, you know, we got, and the picture I got to paint, because I wish we still had pictures of this, but we walk into the guy's room, and we, you know, imagine, you know, a 16-year-old's bedroom female with, like, the NSYNC and the Backstreet Boys, posters all over the wall. This was Wu-Tang Clan. RZA, Method Man, the whole crew, every part of his room. We had a gang symbol. We had the penciled, and this is no joke, a pencil drawing of a gang symbol up on the ceiling. Highland Park crew was official. And I was like, look at this guy, dude. Like this is, you know, this is a hardcore guy, you know? You know, this is like, he's gonna be our fullback, you know? So I was all right with that, you know? And then this is alleged, people, this is alleged, but, you know, asking him about, you know, you want a beer, man? You know, it was a party or something. I don't drink beer. I'm allergic. Hey, do you have a Smirnoff? Mike's Hard Lemonade. This guy only drinks Smirnoff or Mike's Hard Lemonade for at least the first 3 years of high school. There was liquor? Liquor? No, I'm allergic. Chaney, I'm allergic, all right? I'm serious. Now, we all know where that ended up. That was a decision. He probably didn't like the taste. But, you know, and a couple other decisions down the road, you know, first tattoo, you know, my first tattoo, his second, you know, kitchen table of a random kitchen table getting tattoos, 15 years old. I'm telling the story, this is all his fault, you know. Many decisions over the years, many stupid decisions over the years, but I will say today, after 15 years of some silly, silly decisions, I am the most proud I've ever been. I've had the most fun all day today, hanging out with the guys, having our moment, joking with this guy over the years. And today, I couldn't be more proud of my best friend. He is making one heck of a decision. Melanie, you are perfect for Prince. You are patient. You have the patience of anybody I know. You are smart when to yell at this guy, to stay on this man, and you guys couldn't, I mean, you're best friends, and I see that every day that I see him. And as a best friend of Prince, I want him to be the most happy, and I know from the bottom of my heart, you made a great freaking decision, dude. Good decisions. To their happiness.
Thank you, Adam. Appreciate that.